press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello children, how are you? I hope that all are doing good at home, is it? And not only enjoying at home, and you are learning also. So never miss learning and never miss the classes, okay? So today I am here with you with the new lesson. The name of the lesson is The Selfish Giant. And this lesson was written by the Oscar Wilde. Who has written? Oscar Wilde. He was born on 16 October 1854. He belongs to Ireland. He born in the place Dublin, which belongs to Ireland. And he was an Irish poet and a playwright. Okay, and he has written some of the great works. So which are the great works here? The great works are The Picture of Dorian Gray, The Importance of Being Earnest, The Intentions. So these are the notable works of Oscar Wilde. And what is this lesson? The Selfish Giant. What is the word called selfish? Selfish, we all know that. Who are having excess desires. So the person is thinking about himself. Okay, him or herself. So that is called as a selfish. And what is this giant? So giant means a huge person. I have written here the meaning of the giant. A huge person. A tall person. A gigantic figure, you can say. Okay. It's called as a huge person. And while you are while I'm explaining this lesson, so you have to keep your textbook in your hand. Okay. And underline the difficult words, what I am telling you, and write down the meanings, whatever I am saying here. And it is helpful for you, for your reference and for the exam purpose. Okay. So this is the important thing I wanted to tell you guys. So now I'm going to start this lesson. So what is this? The Selfish Giant. The lesson is about a person who is a huge person, a giant figure. He had a garden, a beautiful garden. Okay, but he had been went to some of the friend house. So all the children were gathered in his garden and they were playing, they are enjoying. So in that garden, the flowers, the trees, okay, and everywhere it looks like a colorful, amazing, attractive to the children. Okay, and the birds are singing song. So when the children are playing there, even the place also looking like it's the most beautiful place in the world. Okay, so here I wanted to tell you that in the introduction. So this lesson is divided into two parts, that is part one and part two. So before I am going to read the lesson, here there is the introduction about the lesson. The giant's garden was beautiful and children loved to play it. Okay, so he had a beautiful garden. So always the children loved to go there, okay, and to play there. The giant was a selfish, but this person, he was a selfish man. Built a high wall round his lovely garden. So when he come to know about the children are coming there to play, so he built a wall around the garden, which the children, they never enter this garden. Okay, then children did not enter the garden thereafter, nor did spring and summer till the giant experienced a change of heart. So when children stop to visit that garden for the play, so even the season also not appeared, the season also not experienced by the giant, this person. Okay, not the spring season came and not only the summer season came. Okay, so till then this person he has not changed his heart. So till then the spring, the summer, the beautiful seasons which were not arises there. Okay, so let's see what is the lesson here. I'm going to read here, so listen it carefully, and when I am explaining, underline the important words, what you are getting difficult there, and which are the meanings I am saying here. So write down that meanings for those difficult words. Okay, Every afternoon, as they were coming from school, the children used to go and play in the Jane's garden. It was a large, lovely garden with soft green grass. Here and there over the grass stood beautiful flowers like stars, and there were 12 peach trees that in the springtime broke out into delicate blossoms of pink and pearl, and in the autumn bore rich fruit. The birds sat on the trees and sang so sweetly that the children used to stop their games in order to listen to them. "How happy we are here," they cried to each other. One day, the Jane came back. He had been to visit his friend, the Cornish Ochre, and had stayed with him for 7 years. When he arrived, he saw the children playing in the garden. "What are you doing here?" he cried in a very gruff voice, and the children ran away. Okay, so let's say from the beginning. Every afternoon, so when the children come from the school, so what they are doing there, as they were coming from school, the children used to go and play in the Jane's garden. Okay, so it's about the daily routine of our children. So when they will come from the, when they came from the school, they used to go to that garden for the play. Okay, and that is the Jane's garden. Whose garden? Jane's garden. So who is the Jane here? A person who has this garden, a beautiful garden. So there the children are going, children are visit there to play there. Okay, it was a large, lovely garden. So that garden is a beautiful place, okay, with soft green grass. So the garden is covered with the green grass, which is soft. Here and there over the grass stood beautiful flowers like stars, and there were 12 peach trees that in the springtime broke out into delicate blossoms of pink, pearl, and in the autumn bore rich fruit. Okay, so in that garden there is a green grass, and here and there, so in that green grasses there are some flowers. So how the flowers are looking? So they are looks like a stars. Okay, so they are stood. Okay, they are stood like a stars. Then, and there were 12 peach trees. Peach means it's kind of a fruit. Okay, so it's more in England. Okay, England, that is in Europe continent. So peach trees that in the springtime. So that fruit, it's going to be broke out into delicate. Then during the springtime, and broke out into delicate blossoms of pink and pearl. Okay, so it blossoms means which is going to be a take a bloom, means blossoms which come out, that is which is in a pink and pearl color, and in the autumn bore rich fruit. Before the fruit is going to be bore out, means came out from the trees, so there will be the small buds. Okay, the small buds which is in a pink and pearl color. The birds sat on the trees and sang so sweetly that the children used to stop their games in order to listen to them. Okay, so where the flowers, the fruits, where the green trees, and there is a huge the grasses, it looks there in that place, the birds are also attracted to that place, not only the children. So while playing, children, they stop to listen the music, they stop that games to listen the music of the birds. Okay, then how happy we are here. So while listening that music of the birds, so they are talking each other, how happy we are, we are enjoying this a wonderful moment when the birds are singing. And they cried to each other. Cried means they are talking with each other with happily. One day the Jane came back. So this is the daily routine of these children. Okay, so daily after they complete finishing of their school, then they used to go to that garden. Okay, for the playing. And next, in one day, the Jane came back because he was visit to the one of his friend. The friend name is Cornish Ochre. Okay, so who is the friend name of the Jane? The Cornish Ochre. Ochre. He was a friend of Jane. He had been to this friend for 7 years. Okay. After 7 years, he is visiting to his place, his home. Who? The Jane. When he arrived, he saw the children playing in the garden. So when he arrived to his home, so he saw that the children are playing in his garden. Then suddenly he has said something. What? What are you doing here? So he cried in a very gruff manner, very gruff voice, with the hard voice. He said that. What are you doing here? And the children ran away with the fear. So the children ran away. So after listen the words of the giant, then, my own garden is my own garden. Okay. This is belongs to me. Who said this? The giant. He said that it is not belong to any of the person. It belongs to me, only me. Said the giant. Anyone can understand that I will allow nobody to play in it but myself. So he built a high wall, all round it, and put up a notice board. Okay. So what he said here? When he looks that the children are playing there, he said that, so this is belongs to me, this garden belongs to me, only me. Okay. So then, and no one can understand it. If anyone cannot understand this, so they have to pay for it. What it is, the condition of the gene, I will allow nobody to play in it but myself. So nobody is enter in this garden and they are not playing here, only myself. He is going there in the garden. Okay, he has stated. So he built a high wall around, all round it. So because of to avoid the children come in that garden, so he built a high wall. Okay, so around the garden, and put up a notice board, and he has written in that board, and he was kept outside the wall. Okay, he hanged outside the wall. So what he did is that trespassers will be prosecuted. Okay, so he has written something on the board, so it is called as a notice board. Okay, so like that, in that board he has written something. What he has written there? Here there is a words are there, that is trespassers will be prosecuted. Okay, which means trespass means here the meaning given here in your textbook, those who enter somebody's land property without his or her permission. Okay, those people who are visiting to the land without the permission of the owner. Okay, so that person are called as a trespassers. So will be prosecuted means punished. Okay, so he will get punished under the law. So that one was written on the board. Then he was very selfish giant. Okay, he was a very selfish giant. The poor children had now nowhere to play. They tried to play on the road, but the road was very dusty and full of hard stones, and they did not like it. Okay, so the children are loved to go to that garden, but he has written, who the Jane person has written something on the board. So how can he enter there? How those children are entered into the garden? So they used to go to the road for the playing, but the road is full of dust and smoke and hard stones, so they can't play there. Okay, and they did not like it, and that place they are not liking, so they are going to play on the road. They used to wander around high walls, and when their lessons were over, and talk about the beautiful garden inside, how happy we were there, they said to each other. Okay, so what he said, what the children are saying here, the children are wandering round the wall. Okay, so where? Near the garden. Okay, they are wandering, they are looking there, how can they are going to enter into that garden, but they can't. After they finishing their classes, so their school, then they are used to wander around the garden and talk about the beautiful garden. So when the children are make a group, they are used to talk about a beautiful garden, how they were playing in that garden. And here they said, how happy we were there. How happy we were there in the garden. How happily we were playing there. How happily we were enjoying in that garden. Okay. So like that, they are said each other. Then the spring came, and all over the country there was a little blossoms and little birds. Okay. Only in the garden of the selfish giant, it was still winter. Okay. So after the season, after the winter season, there was a spring season. Okay. So where? In this place. But actually, so except this giant house, so other people are enjoying the spring season. But there is no spring season appeared in this place. Still, it was not appear there. And then only in the garden of the selfish, it will still remain a winter. The birds did not care to sing in it as there were no children, and the trees forgot to blossom. Okay. The trees are not blossom, okay, with the flowers, and the children and the birds are also not visiting to that garden because it is covered with the snow. It is in a winter season, and these the birds also not like the winter season. Okay. So then once a beautiful flower put its head out from the grass, but when it saw the notice board, it was so sorry for the children that it slipped back into the ground again and went off to sleep. Okay. So once a beautiful flower, so it was blossom, it was put its head out. Okay. Put its head out means it is coming out from the grass. But when it saw who the flower saw the that board, that is what notice board, so which was written the children should not allow in the garden. It is not about the children, that is called the transgressors will be prosecuted. So they feel that sorry about to the children, and again he went inside the grass. Then they slipped back into the ground again and went off to sleep. Okay. So again that flower went into the sleep. The only people who were pleased were the snow and the frost. So in that only one garden, in that only one particular garden, that is giant garden, so the garden is experiencing only the winter season. So all around there are a snow and frost. Okay. So everywhere there is a snow and frost. There is no grasses, there is no flowers, there is no birds, there is no children, and there is no the birds are used to come there. Okay. So it is covered with the snow and also frost. Okay. The springer, what is this snow and frost? Here is the difference between the snow and frost. Snow which is falling from the sky. Okay, then it is called white icing. The frost is called white icing. So only these two things are looking everywhere. Okay, when the giant is looking there, he feels that only these things are there, which is snow and winter, snow and frost. The spring has forgotten this garden. Actually, the spring has forgotten to this garden to come there. They cried. So we will live here all the year around. The snow covered up the grass with a great white cloak, and the frost painted all the trees silver. Okay. Here says that spring has forgotten this garden. So everywhere they are enjoying the spring. The other people, they are enjoying the spring season. But here in this particular garden, the spring has not arrived. Okay. They cried. Who? That garden. So we will live here all the year like this. So we have to live like this in the snow and this frost. The snow covered up the grass with her great white cloak. Cloak means blanket. It is a kind of a blanket which is used to covering. Okay. So everywhere the white snow has covered. There is no green grasses. There is no leaves on the trees. The frost painted all the trees silver. There is no green leaves on the trees. So the trees are looking like a silver color. Okay. So there is a frost on the trees. Then they invited the north wind to stay with them, and he came. So after the winter season, the winter season invited to the north wind air. Okay. What is this? after the winter season. After this winter season, so the time has the season has skipped. That is spring. Okay, so that has not arrived. But this winter season calls to north wind. North wind. Okay. So it calls to north wind. They invited to north wind to stay with them, and he came. Who came? That is north wind. Who invited? The winter season. It has invited to north wind, and he came. See here, north wind is comparing to he. So in that sentence, the he is comparing to the north wind. He was wrapped in furs and he rode all day, but the garden and the blue chimney puts down. Okay, the wind is blowing everywhere, so which is particular in the garden. Okay, which is used to blow everywhere, and the furs he rode. He rode means the air pressure is very high in that garden. All day about the garden, and blew the chimney pots down. So it is blowing. Okay, it is blowing very fast, which is chimney falls down. Chimney, you know the chimneys. So it is a roof. There it is a chimney. So how? Because of the air pressure, the wind pressure, the chimney puts down. Okay, what is that? Is north wind. This is delightful spot, he said. So who said? This north wind. Okay. So who said here the sentence? This is a delightful spot. The north wind said that it is very interesting place. It is very attractive place to enjoy it. He said we must ask Hale on a visit. So then north wind calls to Hale's. So this place is very beautiful. Who said this? North wind. And he calls to Hale's. Hale's on a visit. So the Hale came. So next, who came after the north wind? That is Hale's. You know the Hale's? It is a kind of ice, but it is not ice. Okay? Just a minute, I will rub this. So like, then you will understand. If I write some pictures on the board. So like this, a small, the icy particles, okay, that is called hails. So it is, sometimes it is a big, or sometimes it is very small. So when it is hit to the person, or when it is hit to the things, so it will be breakout, okay? So it will be broken. So here also, what the hails did. So the hail came every day for 3 hours. He rattled on the roof of the castle till he broke most of the slates. And then he ran round and round the garden as fast as he could go. He was dressed in grey and his breath was like ice. Okay. So next, after the north wind, the hails are arrived, visited. And what they had did in this castle, in this garden. So here written here, every day for 3 hours. The hails are coming to this garden for 3 hours. Every day for 3 hours. Then, and he rattled on the roof of the castle. So this is a huge castle. So this Jane, the Jane person who has a huge castle. Castle means it's like a palace. Okay, palace. And there he has a beautiful garden. Okay. Then, so that hails are known, when it is hit to the castle, it has break the slates. Break the slates means the roof, like this. The slates means which is constructed with the tiles. The roof which is constructed with the tiles. It has break the slates. Then he ran round and round the garden as fast as he could go. So what is this hails? So it is moving around this garden. Okay, round and round and round. So it is moving. He was dressed in grey and his breath was like ice. So who's? The hails. It looks like a grey in colour. And it breathes. When it breathes, it is icy. Okay? So it is a icy feeling. When it breathes. Then, I cannot understand why the spring is so late in coming, said the selfish giant. So when he observed this kind of atmosphere in his garden, he was shocked, he was amazed, he was surprised. Why the spring season is not arriving in my garden? So what I told you, the spring season has not come because of the children, because the children also not visiting to that garden. So that's why the spring is also not arriving here. So who is arriving? Who is visiting here? That is winter. After winter, the winter calls the north wind. The north wind calls the hills. Okay? Then he is surprised to see this atmosphere. To see this weather. Sorry, it's not atmosphere. It's a weather. After seeing this, so he is very surprised about the weather of this place. Then, as he sat on the window and looked out at his cold white garden, I hope there will be a change in the weather. So who sat? The Jane person. The Jane, a selfish Jane, who was sitting inside from his room and is looking out. So he is looking out from the window and it was covered with a cold and white garden. Okay. So the garden is covered with a white snow. Then I hope there will be change in the weather. So he's hoping that there must be changing in the weather, but the spring never came. He is hoping that the weather will going to be changed, but the spring season is not came. Then nor the summer. After the spring, the summer also not came. The two seasons were not came. So who are those? The spring season and the summer season. Okay, these two seasons were not came to this garden. Not came to this garden. The autumn gave golden fruit to every garden, but to the Jane's garden she gave none. Okay. So after this monsoon season, the autumn season came, but it has not given any fruit. So other trees, so he looks there will be the golden color fruits, okay? But in the Jane's garden, so there is no fruits, okay? There is no fruits there. He is too selfish. This man, the Jane, is too much selfish. Okay, she said. Who said? That is autumn season said. Okay, so autumn season said to Jane. So what she said? She said about this man, he is too much selfish. He is too selfish. Then she gave none, he's too selfish, she said. So it was always winter there, and the north wind and the hail and the frost and snow danced about through the trees. Okay, so autumn said here, because this man is selfish, too selfish, so that's why in his garden, so there is no spring season visited there, only the winter season, then the north wind and the hails are arriving, and only the snow and ice, means the snow and frost, so they are dancing over the trees. Okay, they only stay there. Then next is, one morning the Jane was lying awake in bed when he heard some lovely music. So in one day, so Jane, a man, he has heard that something noise when he was lying on the bed. So he was awake and he listened some lovely music. It sounded so sweet to his ears that he thought it must be the king's musicians passing by. So that music, it is so lovely to hear. And he thought that there must be the king's musician he used to sing there. It was really only a little linnet singing outside his window. But it was so long since he had heard a bird singing in his garden that it seemed to him to be the most beautiful music in the world. Linnet, hear the word called little linnet. Linnet. Linnet means a brownish songbird found in Europe. Okay, linnet means a brownish songbird which is found in especially in Europe. So this is called a linnet. It is a bird which is found in Europe. Then it is singing there. Okay, so it is singing outside his window. When he looks outside, he has seen that the linnet bird is used to sing there. But it was so long, so that music what he has heard, it was so long to him, he has never heard it, this kind of a music. Bird singing in his garden, that it seemed to him to be the most beautiful music in the world. So one of the bird, it is singing there. So after a long time, he saw that and he listened the music of the bird in his own garden. And that music is one of the most beautiful music in the world. Okay. Then the hail stopped. So after that, the hail was stopped. It was stopped. So when the bird is singing song there, after hearing this sound, the music, the beautiful music, so then the hail was stopped. Dancing over his head, and the north wind ceased roaring, and delicious perfume came to him through the open casement. Okay, so after that, the north wind also ceased. It is also stopped. Ceased means stopped. Okay, it is also stopped, and there was a beautiful means it was a delicious perfume coming from the garden. Okay, so what it is, open casement. Casement means window that opens on hinges like a door. Okay, so from the window doors, so the delicious perfume, so it was coming inside the home, in the room. And I believe the spring has come at last. So now the jain, this person is believing that now at last the spring season has arrived. Okay, said the jain, and he jumped out of the bed and looked out suddenly with a happy and he looked out when he smells the delicious perfume. So this is about the first part. The next is, we will move on to the second part. Next, what happened here to the jain and his lovely garden? To celebrate the return of the children, trees covered themselves with the birds and the blossoms. So the children, after all, they came to the garden. They are visiting to this garden. And after the children were arriving there, everywhere the flowers are blossoms and the fruits are also. The birds are all singing there. The jain was delighted to see his friends back, especially the little boy who he loved dearly. So in this lesson, this jain, he changed his heart from a selfish to, so he was open-hearted man. Okay, so then he allows to children to come into the garden. The children boy soon disappeared, only to return the much later. Okay, so let's see what happened in this lesson, in this story. He saw a most wonderful sight through the little hole in the wall the children had crept in. So who saw? This jain. The jain has saw that through the little hole in the wall the children had crept in. So the children are coming in. They are moving inside the garden. So who saw that? The jain has seen that. And they were sitting on the branches of the trees. So those children, they are coming inside with the small hole from the wall, and they coming in, they are moving in. Crept means moving in. So it is a past participle verb, that is a crept, and present tenses, that is present verb is creep. Okay. Then in every tree that he could see, there was a little child. So everywhere in each of the branches, so the children are sitting there. Okay, on the branches. And the trees were so glad to have the children back again that they had covered themselves with the blossoms and were waving their arms gently above the children's heads. Okay, so when the trees are looked there, the children are coming inside, and they used to sit on the branches, and everywhere that these trees are welcoming to the children, and it was covered with the blossoms. The trees are covered with the blossoms, and they are weaving with the arms gently above the children's head. So they are waving okay, sorry, it's a waving their arms. So waving their arms to welcoming to these children, to this garden. The birds were flying about and twittering with delight, and flowers were looking up through the green grass and laughing. Okay, so the birds were flying. So when the trees are on the trees, the flowers are blossoms, and everywhere there are green in color. And now the birds are used to come on these trees and in this garden. Okay, and twitter with the delight. So they are delighted. Who? The birds are. And the flowers were looking up through the green grass and laughing. So what? When you can see that in a part first of the lesson. So when they saw the board, that is notice board, so the children are not coming inside the garden. So the flower which is wanted to come out from the grass. So when it saw the board, it went inside. Okay. Then so when the flowers also look there, the trees are in a green in color, the grass is also green in color. The children used to play here in this garden, and the bird is also singing song. So the flowers used to come out. Okay. So they also started come out from the grass, and they are also laughing. The flower also laughing. It was lovely scene. So that scene is very lovely. It is so attractive. Okay. Then only one corner, it was a still winter. So it is a huge garden. Okay. And there is a one of the corner of the garden. So still there is a winter. Okay. Then what happened to that place? It was a farthest corner of the garden. Farthest means it is that place, it is far from this place. So where the children are playing, it is far away from that place. It is the farthest corner of the garden. And it was standing a little boy. So there it was a small boy who are standing to that corner. Okay, so where the winter season still it is there. Then he was so small that he could not reach up to the branches of the tree, and he was wandering all round it crying bitterly. So that boy is too small, he can't reach to the branches of the trees. He is crying very badly, and then he used to jump on the branches, but he can't because he is too small boy. He's wandering all round it. He's wandering near the tree, but he can't. So that's why he was crying. The poor tree was still covered with frost and snow. That tree, that in the corner of that garden, so where the boy is used to go jump on the branches, so that tree is covered with the snow and frost. And the north wind was also blowing and roaring about it. So that tree is covered with the snow and also the frost. Still the north wind is also blowing, okay, blowing and above it, and climb up little boy, said the tree. So now the tree calls to the little boy, climb up, okay, climb up, little boy, said the tree. And it bent its branches down as low as it could, but the boy was too tiny. So when the tree is trying to take that boy on its arms, it just bent its branches, who? The tree. And he just calling it to come on the branches, but he can't, but he couldn't, because that boy is too small to jump. He was too tiny, means it's just too small. And the Jane's heart melted as he looked up. So when he saw that the beautiful scene. So the boy, the tiny boy, he is used to trying to jump on the tree, and the tree is also bending, okay? And that tree is also taking that boy in its arm. So the Jane heart is melted here, okay? So then what he does, how selfish I have been, he said. He said about himself, how selfish I was, okay? Then he said, now I know why the spring would not come here. So when he see that, when he compared here, the children are playing, they are on the trees, they are on the branches, and the birds are singing, the flowers came out, everywhere there are blossoms on the trees, and everything it is there. And there the corner, the children still is trying to jump, still is trying to go onto the branches, but the tree is also trying, but he can't. So there he compared the two situations. So I understand that why the spring season is not came to my garden, these many days why it is not came. So he understand that, okay? And garden became winter, but when the child would not come here, I will put that poor little boy on the top of the tree and then I will knock down the wall and my garden shall be the children's play ground forever and ever. He was really very sorry for what he had done. Okay, so when he looked at, when he looks at the child, he is too small boy that he wanted to jump on the branches. Okay, so he feels it. Oh, the giant, he feels it. I will keep this boy on the branch. I will put this boy on the branch and I will, what he has constructed, that wall. So he said that he will knock down the wall. Knock down means he will break the wall. And he always is welcoming the children. And this garden is belongs to children forever, he decided. Okay, this is belongs to children. Garden shall be the children's playground. So it becomes a children's playground ever and ever. He was really very sorry about what he has done. He feels sorry about what he was done earlier with these children. Okay, so this is about the today's class. So I will continue with the remaining story with the next class. Okay, I hope that all are enjoyed and all are imagining that what kind of a situation in this story, and how the children are enjoying while they are playing, and how this giant person, this man who is a giant in figure, is in his physique, he changed his heart because he was too selfish. Okay, so how he was experienced the season and why the spring season has not arrived in his garden. Okay, when the children used to stop to come to that garden, so why they are not came here, and how he has changed his, and how he has transferred his heart because of that scene. Okay, so this is about the lesson. I hope that you all are enjoyed it. So I will continue in the next class. So all of you stay at home, keep learning. Thank you all of you.